Welcome back, friends, in my YouTube channel Microbial 2020. Now I will discuss on the topic beta arrestin pathway, also called as desensitization. We know about the beta adrenergic pathway outlook here. Epinephrine binds to the receptor, then activate the G protein, then catalyze the adenosyl cyclase and signal transduction process carried and response obtained. This is the beta adrenergic pathway. Okay. Desensitization is a process that diminishes the responses to either negative or positive stimulus after the repeated exposure to it. This is desensitization. At usual, in a single transducing system has to turn off after the hormonal or other stimulus has ended, and the mechanism for shutting off from the signal are intrinsic to all the signaling system. That is, most of the systems adapt to continue the presence of the signal by becoming less sensitive to it by desensitization. And the beta adrenergic system have both resensitization and desensitization. Here we focus on the desensitization, means how to terminate the beta adrenergic response. What is the exact desensitization? Means how to terminate the beta adrenergic response. Which proteins used in this pathway? In this pathway, beta adrenergic protein kinase and beta arrestin, these two pathway two proteins used in this pathway. The beta adrenergic receptor is desensitized by the phosphorylation and by association with arrestin. The function of these two proteins I will explain from this figure. Beta arrestin pathway here. This is the receptor. Epinephrine binds to the beta adrenergic receptor that triggers the dissociation of the GS beta gamma subunit from the GS unit. And desensitization of the beta adrenergic receptor is mediated by the protein kinase that phosphorylate the receptor on the intracellular domain of the normally interacts with the G protein. Okay. When the receptor remains occupied with the epinephrine, see, this receptor remains occupied with the epinephrine, the beta adrenergic receptor kinase, this beta adrenergic receptor kinase, also called as the GRK2, this phosphorylates the several residues of the serine at the carboxyl terminus of the receptor, which is on the cytoplasmic center of the plasma membrane. Here, GS beta gamma subunit recruits the beta ARK, beta adrenergic receptor kinase, to the membrane, where it dephosphorylates the serine residue at the carboxyl terminus of the receptor. Then, protein kinase A activated with the help of the cyclic AMP, and then phosphorylates and again activates the beta ARK. Okay, then this beta ARK is drawn to the plasma membrane by the association with the is drawn in the plasma membrane by the association with the G protein, GS beta gamma subunit, and then phosphorylates to the and phosphorylate and activated the beta ARK. Activated the beta ARK. And phosphorylate the activated beta ARK to the receptor. Then receptor phosphorylates. This receptor phosphorylates the and create the binding site for the beta arrestin. What? This receptor by beta ARK protein to the this GS beta gamma recruits the beta ARK to the membrane where it phosphorylates the serine residue at the carboxyl terminus of the receptor. Okay, then protein beta this beta ARK is drawn to the plasma membrane by its association with the GS beta gamma subunit and phosphorylate the receptor. And this phosphorylate the receptor, and this receptor phosphorylated and creates the binding site for the beta arrestin, also called as the beta ARR and arrestin 2. Okay, this beta arrestin binds to the phosphorylated carboxyl terminal domain of the receptor. Okay, and this binding of beta arrestin blocks the site, the receptor that interact with the G protein. What is the function? This beta arrestin binding of beta arrestin blocks the site in the receptor that interact with the G protein. Okay. Then next, the binding of beta arrestin of the receptor, binding of the beta arrestin of the receptor molecule, the removal from the plasma membrane by endocytosis into the small intracellular vesicle. Okay, here the receptor arrestin complex removed from the plasma membrane and enter the cell by endocytosis. The arrestin receptor complex and clathrin and other proteins involved in a vesicle formation, which initiate the membrane invagination and leading to the formation of endosome containing the adrenergic receptor. How to produce the adrenergic receptor? The receptor arrestin receptor complex and clathrin and other proteins used in vesicle formation, which initiate the membrane invagination leading to the formation of endosomes and containing the adrenergic receptor. Okay, in this state the receptor are inaccessible. In this state, the receptor are inaccessible to epinephrine. That is, in this state, the receptor has not ability to bind the epinephrine. Okay. Then, therefore, inactive. Then, this receptor molecule Dephosphorylated and returned to the plasma membrane, returned to the surface of the plasma membrane. Okay, then this receptor molecule surface to the plasma membrane, then completing the whole circuit and resensitize the system to epinephrine. Got it? These all are the beta arrestin pathway. Okay. How to terminate the beta adrenergic pathway with the help of beta arrestin protein? Okay. Then summary of this topic. When the epinephrine signal persists, beta adrenergic receptor specific protein kinase and beta arrestin temporarily desensitize the receptor and cause it to move into the intracellular vesicle. Thank you. Now I will stop here.